Hey everyone, and welcome to a moment of family mental health. Well, friends, I wonder if you are like me, where sometimes you have a need or a longing inside, but then when it comes out of your mouth, it just doesn't get expressed the way you had wanted it to, and conflict follows. So sometimes our approach can be off, our timing can be off, the tone we use can be off. And I think a significant factor that's at play sometimes is that we can also bring criticism or blame or attack into that conversation. And then it leaves the other person feeling defensive, attacked, belittled, disrespected, and the list goes on and on. And so today I want to invite us to consider using really simple language that may feel awkward at first, but it's powerful in its delivery and in its effect. And it's simply saying, I need, and I feel. And you can switch them, whichever one you want to say first, go for it. So for me, I might say, I'm feeling scared. I don't know how to navigate through this decision, and I need you to stay with me, support me in it a little bit, and have a bit more of a conversation. Or it may look like, I need you to support me, instead of, I don't need you to tell me what to do. Do you see how that latter comes with some defensiveness, some demeaning messages right there attached to it? But if I can say, I need you to support me, I'm feeling criticized, it brings a whole different element into the interaction with another person. And so consider that as you think about how you express needs to your spouse, if you're married, to children, if you have them, but also even to how you express needs within your workplace or friendships. A lot of times we have needs and we think we're attempting to communicate them, but they don't come out the way that we want. And so I invite you to consider using that simple phrase of I feel and I need. Friends, it may seem a little awkward, it may sound a little funny, maybe even a little therapeutic, if you will. But think about if I taught you how to use a new stroke in tennis. It would feel a little funny at first as well, until I'm learning how to use that tennis racket with that new stroke. So this is very similar. Until I get consistent or regular in that pattern, it may feel a little awkward. But once I do it and I see the impact that it leaves the other person still feeling respected, not emotionally heightened, not flooded, but able to respond really clearly back to me, it will become a habit I think you'll want to use. Friends, the other piece to this is that often behind those negative emotions, there's a core longing, a deep need and desire. And so if we can pause and identify, what is it that I really want? Oh, I really want belonging. Then what will come out is, I feel scared that I don't have a place. I really need a place with you. I really need belonging. It invites that other person, that I'm expressing vulnerability to the other person and inviting an opportunity for more love to be given back to me, instead of maybe shutting down or saying like, oh, it's no big deal. If I can think about what it is that I really need, that exchange, that interactional exchange will work out a lot differently. I'm confident of it. And so will you join with me in attempting a new way of speaking our needs, pausing, identifying what that core need is, and then expressing, I feel, I need, without the place of criticism or blame. All right, let's go do it. Thanks.